Hangout channel. In this video, we will discuss about wrapper classes in Java. We all know Java is not a pure object-oriented programming language. The reason behind that is it works on primitive data types. To use primitive data types in the form of objects, we use wrapper classes. Wrapper classes are in Java mainly objects, which makes code full object oriented. So in Java there are total of 8 primitive data types, and we need 8 different separate wrapper classes, right? Already in Java, built in Java, we have 8 wrapper classes with respect to 8 primitive data types. We'll see this one. So primitive data types and their wrapper classes. For example, this is the primitive data type byte. Wrapper class is byte. What is the difference between both? Only primitive data types starts with small letter and classes starts with caps letter. By seeing that one only, we can find out which is primitive data type and which is wrapper class. Like short, S is small and wrapper class short, S is caps. Here int, it's completely different between both. And respective wrapper class is integer, long, L is small, long, L is caps, because this is wrapper class. Float, float, double, double, boolean, boolean, and char, char is a primitive data type, and character is a wrapper classes, like 8 primitive data types and 8 wrapper classes with respect to primitive data types. Whenever requirement is there to convert the any primitive data type, for example int value is there, we need to convert that into object to utilize in some business scenario, then we will use integer wrapper classes, which is correspond to int. Same like long value is there. Our business requirement demands to use the object. Then we must convert that primitive value into respective object. So that time we use long wrapper class. So like that, there are many advantages. So mainly we use wrapper classes to convert the primitive value into object. So byte into byte object, short value into short object, int value into int value int object, long value into long object. These are the 8. That is the main advantage. And the second one is, in Java, if you see, there are a lot of packages. Java.lang, java.util. Java.util package contains the classes. Those classes handles only objects. In that scenario, we must need wrapper classes to convert the primitive into object. And third benefit is data structures like set, list. Those are deals with objects, not with the primitive values. So whenever if you want to store the integers, so we cannot store as a primitive data type. That must be converted into integer object, then only we can save, or we can save in the we can add to the list. And fourth advantage is in multi-threading environment, we need object to support the synchronization. There also we need this wrapper classes. These are the main advantages with respect to wrapper classes. So if you see hierarchy of these wrapper classes, so in Java, supermost class is object. From there only all the subclasses will be there. So if you see in this diagram, object is a superclass and number is a subclass of object. Character is a subclass of object. Boolean is a subclass of object. Again, this numeric wrapper classes are 6. So byte, short, int, long, float, and double, which are the subclass of number. So this number is already implemented serializable interface. So to transfer the values from one place to another place, we need serializable. And these wrapper classes, whatever wrapper classes, byte, short, integer, long, float, double, these are also implemented clonable interface. These are the hierarchy as per Java API. So these are the main wrapper classes and primitive classes. We have seen what are the wrapper classes and what are the primitive data types. When we need to convert the primitive data types into wrapper classes, those things. Then let's see how can we convert the primitive data type into wrapper class. Wrapper class into primitive data type, string into wrapper, string into wrapper class object, string into primitive data type. Those things we will see. I draw a small diagram. So if value is in the form of a string, if you want to convert that value into primitive value, then we will use integer dot parse int. If you see this arrow mark, integer into the primitive value, so parse int. So xxx indicates either it is int, float, double, anything. All we can replace with all 8 parameter this wrapper classes: parse int, parse float, parse double, like that. So if we want to convert vice versa primitive value into string, so when in generally in real time applications, in real time projects, so we will get the input as a string, integer value also. Later we have to convert into the integer to compare the values, so to do the some logic, execute the logics. So in that scenario, we will convert a string into primitive, and primitive into string, there is a toString method. This is not toString, it should be string dot value of. String dot string is a class, value of is a object, which will take the primitive value as a input and it will return the string. Okay, then some cases there might scenarios where we need to convert string into wrapper class object. Exactly, not primitive value, wrapper class object. That time what we do, integer dot value of, there is a integer is a wrapper class which contains the value of method, which takes the string as a input and returns the object of that respective wrapper class. And same way, we can convert wrapper class object into string. Any object we can convert into string by using two string most of the times. That is the one. This is a string to wrapper class object, string to primitive values. We can convert by using these are the methods. Main thing is wrapper class object into primitive, primitive into wrapper class object. For example, there is a primitive value which needs to be converted into object. So we can directly convert that one. For example, take int x is equal to 10 is there. I want to convert that one into the object because to store into the collection. So what we can do, we can directly create the integer in object by passing that primitive value. There are different constructors are there. Like that, we can convert a primitive value into wrapper class object in different way, like in reverse way. If you want to convert the wrapper class object into primitive value, then we have to use this one, int value. So if integer is a wrapper class object, integer variable class object is there, then int value, float object is there, then we have to use float value, like that we can convert. So before Java 1.5 we will do this one. We used to do this conversion, variable class object into primitive value into proper class object explicitly by using these methods. After JDK 1.5, some people introduced auto boxing and auto unboxing. So auto boxing is nothing but converting the primitive value into object. So automatically is called auto boxing. Unboxing, it is quite a reverse way of auto boxing, means converting a wrapper object into primitive value directly without using any methods. That is the beauty of auto boxing and unboxing. We no need to perform more steps to convert the object into primitive into object. Okay, these are the theoretical explanation about wrapper classes. We will see practical also. In the diagram, what I showed, first step is a string to wrapper object, wrapper object to string, string to primitive value to string. You will see the respective example. So line number 8, so string to integer. So for example, if we get any input value as a string which represents the integer, then we need to convert that one into the integer wrapper object. Then we will use integer dot value of method. So this is a interview question: how can you convert the value, the string, into integer? So simple answer is integer dot value of. So this integer is a class and value is a static method inside integer. If you see public static integer value of, so this value of method takes the string and converts into object, string object. So that is the one. And if you see, it is showing instead of string, if string contains the integer value, then fine. If it contains a character, then it will return the number format exception. So it is throws number format exception. Okay, that is the one. So we can convert. And the second thing is converting a string to integer to string. So line number 11. So already int ref is a integer object, and from there we are converting that object into the string by using toString method. Now string to int primitive data type. So for example, input value is string, and that has to be converted into primitive data type, respective primitive data type value. So so in this scenario, line number 14, string value 1 is equal to 20 represents the integer. So we have to convert this string integer into the int value. There is a method inside a string dot value of. If you see this, it will return the integer. Okay, so now wrapper class, main story, wrapper class, this is a string to wrapper class, string to primitive data type, and primitive data type to string, wrapper class to string. It is completed. Okay, so now wrapper to primitive. So line number 20, integer ref is equal to new integer 30. This is the proper class object, integer wrapper class object. I want to get the integer value from this wrapper class. So integer integer object dot int value. So here, if you see int java.long.integer.int value, this is the method public int value. So this int value method doesn't take any arguments, just it will read the value from that object and return to the this variable. That's it. So easily we can convert. This story is before Java 1.5 till Java 1.4. Okay, wrapper class to wrapper class, not string to wrapper class, primitive to wrapper classes. There are two ways we can use integer dot value of how we used here, converting a string to wrapper class, integer dot value. There are different methods are there. If you see this one, integer java.long.integer.value of it takes a string as a argument. If you see this one, same method. So java.long.integer.value of it is taking integer instead of string. Like there are many overridden value of methods inside the wrapper classes. Okay. So otherwise, another way, second way is there, we can directly create the object of integer by passing that a primitive value. It will automatically convert the primitive value into object. Okay, this story is before JDK 1.5. JDK, after JDK 1.5, auto boxing and unboxing concepts are introduced. So for example, primitive to wrapper class. So here Java auto boxing is used to automatically convert the primitive data types into corresponding objects. Okay, we no need to use any extra methods. We no need to do any extra coding to convert the primitive into corresponding objects. It will automatically convert the primitive data types into corresponding objects. That is the one. For example, line number 29, if you see int I is equal to 10, this is the primitive value. Right, this is the primitive value. If you want to convert that one, you no need to use any classes, directly assign that primitive value to the reference. Compiler will convert that one into the do the extra stuff and convert the object. Okay, this is the auto boxing. Auto boxing is simple, so primitive to object. So unboxing, so it is exactly reverse of auto boxing. Means what is the reverse? What we are doing in auto boxing, we are converting primitive into object. So reverse means object to primitive value. That's it. It converts a wrapper class object into its corresponding primitive data type. For example, autoref, where is autoref? Here integer autoref is equal to I, that means 10. Here what we are doing in line number 34, int unbox is equal to autoref. This is the reference, this is the variable, so it will automatically convert. This is called unboxing. So if you want, we can execute those things. For example, string int ref control space, it will come. If you want to execute, right click on this one, run as, not a run on server, because this is not a web application, it is a general program, right? Java application. See, we are seeing 10, right? Like that. That's all from my end. Thank you for watching the video. Please do subscribe if not. Thank you so much.